Good evening students. Today we will continue with preparation of insoluble salts. How we can prepare insoluble salts? The first method is by synthesis. That is by direct combination of two elements, and when they are heated together then an insoluble salt can be prepared. For example, if we take iron and sulfur, when they are heated together then it forms iron sulfide, FeS, which is an insoluble salt. Similar is the case for lead and sulfur. When lead and sulfur are heated together, then also lead sulfide is formed, PbS, which is also an insoluble salt. The first method to prepare an insoluble salt is by direct combination of two elements, of which one element is a metal and the second one is a non-metal, and when they are heated then an insoluble salt can be prepared. Second method of preparing an insoluble salt is also by direct combination, but here direct combination of two compounds takes place. One compound is a metallic oxide and the second one is a non-metallic oxide. When metallic oxide is heated with non-metallic oxide, then an insoluble salt is prepared. Metallic oxide means basic oxide, non-metallic means acidic oxide. For example, calcium oxide when heated with carbon dioxide, it is a metallic oxide, and it is a non-metallic oxide. When they are heated together, then calcium carbonate is formed, which is a salt. It is an insoluble salt. Similarly, CaO when heated with SO2, sulfur dioxide, then also it forms an insoluble salt, CaSO3, calcium sulfide, which is also an insoluble salt. So it is the second method for preparing an insoluble salt. Third method to prepare an insoluble salt is by double decomposition reaction, that is by precipitation reaction. Third method to prepare an insoluble salt is by double decomposition reaction, that is precipitation reaction. That means one product must be a precipitate, that is insoluble salt. In this process, one soluble salt is reacted with an acid or other soluble salt. Then the product formed is, first is insoluble salt, that is a precipitate, and the second one is soluble salt or acid. See, as for example, when AgNO3, which is a soluble salt, silver nitrate is a soluble salt because all the metallic nitrates are soluble in nature. Okay. When it is treated with an acid, suppose HCl, when it is treated with hydrochloric acid, which is an acid, then one product is AgCl and the second one is HNO3. AgCl is a precipitate here, and AgNO3, when reacted with HCl, then it forms HNO3 and AgCl. AgCl is a precipitate, white color precipitate is formed. See, double decomposition reaction takes place here. Double decomposition means exchange of radicals are taking place here. Silver is positive radical, Ag plus, and NO3 minus, nitrate, is negative radical. Here also H is plus and Cl is minus. Ag combines with Cl because it is positive, it goes to the negative ion and forms AgCl, which is a precipitate here. And H plus goes to the nitrate radical, which is a negative ion, and forms HNO3. So the product formed is, first is insoluble salt and acid is formed here in this reaction. If I have taken here AgNO3 plus NaCl, it is also an insoluble salt and it is also an insoluble salt, then the product formed will be AgCl, which is a precipitate, plus NaNO3, which is a soluble salt. So it is also a double decomposition reaction, or it is a precipitation reaction from which an insoluble salt can be prepared. Similarly, if I have taken BaCl2, barium chloride, which is an insoluble salt, when it is reacted with sodium sulfate, Na2SO4, then it forms BaSO4, which is a precipitate, plus NaCl. Barium combines with sulfate radical, negative ion, and sodium combines with chloride ion, negative ion. Positive goes to the negative and forms sodium chloride. If we have taken sulfuric acid, H2SO4, instead of Na2SO4, then the products formed will be BaSO4 and HCl. Instead of NaCl, the product will be HCl here. It is also the method for preparing an insoluble salt. Similarly, take one more example. If we take lead nitrate, PbNO3 whole 2, which is a soluble salt, plus HCl, then the products are PbCl2, which is insoluble, plus HNO3, nitric acid. PbCl2 is an insoluble salt. PbCl2 is soluble in hot water only, not in cold water. So it is the third method for preparing an insoluble salt. Suppose if we have to prepare lead sulfate is an insoluble salt. Lead sulfate is an insoluble salt. अगर आपको याद हो तो हमने पढ़ा था, all sulfates are soluble except 3 metallic sulfates, and these are CaSO4, PbSO4 and BaSO4.